Hello, welcome to this video. Let's get a quick and complete overview on how to use the newest MAGIX ACID Pro 8. Please leave us comments and suggestions below this video to improve our next video guides dedicated to ACID Pro. MAGIX ACID Pro is a digital audio workstation software used to realize your own audio projects, compositions, and loops with anything you need to apply adjustments and effects with a very simple and immediate user interface. When opening ACID, its interface shows up divided in two. On top, you have the main timeline, where sound files are imported, edited, and adjusted. At the bottom, you have several useful windows collecting most of the features inside ACID, such as the Explorer, the Mixing Console, or the Plugin Manager. In case you miss important panels from the workspace, you can open and recover them from the View tab. To start with a new ACID project, go to New and then start importing files on the timeline, such as samples, MIDI, or visual files. Audio samples are sound files complete with their own mono or stereo sound waveform and a defined instrument. These are all contained inside audio tracks. MIDI files are not rendered with defined notes on the timeline, but with tone and output sound fixed by an external synthesizer chosen. MIDI tracks are provided for these files. All visual files, such as pictures and videos, are contained inside a single video track on top. ACID Pro has very limited options for these files, so you may need to use video editing products such as Vegas Pro or Movie Studio to modify these. Check out our channel to discover more about Vegas Pro or Movie Studio. All these files can be imported by clicking and dragging these into the timeline from either the Explorer panel at the bottom or from any folder you have open. Once added, these files are shown as colored events called clips. Audio samples and MIDI show their own waveform or notes on the timeline, whereas videos show thumbnails and their progressive frame number on themselves. You can check these better by zooming the timeline in and out with your mouse wheel. To move in time quickly, just hold down the Shift key and use the mouse wheel instead. To play back the whole content, you can use the player at the bottom or the Enter and Space keys. These play and stop with the difference that, with the Space key, you still have the starting point of the time marker. In case of visual clips, don't forget to open the Video Preview window in order to check also the visual frames of the project. The time placement of the marker is measured in two ways on the left. The first one shows hours, minutes, seconds, and milliseconds. The second one uses the standard music format in bars, beats, and ticks, according to the time signature chosen at the bottom. Then, bars and beats are rendered into seconds according to the tempo at the bottom, indicated in beats per minute, BPM. A higher tempo increases the speed rate of all the audio and visual files. Although these seem to get stretched since the timeline on top is still measured in bars and beats. To learn more about the time signature and the tempo, check out our links inside the video description. Now, let's see how to edit the timeline clips by using the Draw tool. To move each clip in time or between tracks, just click and drag it. To adjust the clip duration, just click and drag from its edges. By default, the clip snaps to the grid columns of the timeline. But you can avoid this by disabling the snapping button on top. As you stretch and shorten audio clips, these behave differently depending on their ACID type, represented by a dedicated icon beside the clip file name. You can find and change this option by right-clicking on the clip and going to Clip Properties. If you choose one shot, the audio clip content is preserved, so it is not looped or changed in length. You can still adjust its pitch with pitch shift below. When choosing loop, the audio clip will be put in a continuous loop as you stretch, restarting every time you see a gray arrow on it. Moreover, under the Stretch tab, you can stretch or shorten the clip waveform in time by setting the total number of beats for each loop. For example, if you increase the beats number, the clip length will be extended, and so its content will be played slower. More below, you can find the way to stretch the clip, adjusting the time placement of each single beat by moving the green markers on the big graph. If you choose Beat Mapped, you will stretch and shorten the clip content without loops by acting on the sound waveform shape instead of the number of beats. Under General, decide the way to stretch the waveform under Method and Mode. Under Stretch, click and drag the orange markers to act on the waveform. To cut, copy, or paste a clip, just right-click on it. You can make copies of a clip quickly by holding down the Control key and moving it. To delete a clip, just click on it to select it and use the Delete key. To add time offset, just hold down the Alt key and slide on the clip. Whereas, to split a clip into pieces, click on the point where you want to split and use the S key. Pay attention to snappings if they are enabled. If you make any mistake, you can use Ctrl and Z to undo. You can also select multiple clips to edit all of them at the same time. If you hold the Shift key and hover over the clips, you will select all of them, and then you can move and edit them in the same way. ACID Pro has several options to adjust the output sound. On each audio clip, you can click and pull up or down its gain line to adjust its volume. You can also click and drag from its corners on top to add fade in and fade out volume transitions. To change their envelope in time, right-click on these and choose from the fade type list. Moreover, for each audio track, you have several options available on the left side, which affect all the clips contained within it. These are shrinked by default, but you can extend them by dragging the edges of the track. Use the volume bar to adjust the track volume according to the decibel meter color next to Out. Make sure not to have any red color on it, or you may get distortion and saturation on the output. Whereas, use the panning bar to balance the left and right stereo channels. The mute button disables the whole track, muting all its clips inside. It is different than the solo button that disables all the other tracks except the interested one. To delete a track and all of its clips, just right-click on it and go to Delete. All the tracks with their bars and buttons can be found inside the mixing console at the bottom. Here, you can also manage the master track, which is the audio track that collects together all the sound from your project. MIDI clips are the most suitable files to realize compositions and percussions. These are made by defined notes and then rendered through audio instruments called synthesizers, or synths. You can import these .mid files directly on the timeline, or simply create one from scratch. Let's see how to create and compose a new MIDI clip. First of all, create a new MIDI track by right-clicking on the workspace and then going to Insert MIDI Track. Then, with the draw tool enabled, click and drag on the MIDI track to create a new empty MIDI clip. At this point, right-click on the MIDI clip and go to Clip Properties to open the piano roll interface, used to drop and edit notes on the clip. With the draw tool enabled, just click and drag on the piano roll to create your own notes. You can also listen to each note by clicking on the piano roll on the left. You can also leave notes directly on the timeline by using the G key. All the MIDI tracks will show up as integrated piano rolls. By default, the new MIDI track starts with a piano instrument, realized by the DLS soft synthesizer, as you can see from the MIDI track options. If you click on it, you can change the synth to use or add a new one with Insert Soft Synth. Let's check these out quickly. DLS Soft Synth collects several ready presets or voices, which realize pianos, guitars, organs, and even drum kits. Vita is a new synth that generates patterns from the pieces of sound waveforms selected from the top. DNE1 is a very advanced synth. Choose a preset on top and then find the output sound by adjusting each of the audio properties directly from its interface. Depending on the synth chosen, the piano roll renders audio notes or different kinds of percussions and drums. The way to place, move, adjust, and delete each note is identical to what we have seen for the clips on the timeline. On the left side of the MIDI track, you can change the synth preset to use and adjust any volume, panning, or use the mute solo buttons. MIDI tracks are also listed inside the mixing console. With all the synthesizers added, here shown as bus tracks, complete with volume panning bars and mute solo buttons. These act on the MIDI track they are referred to. In case of bus tracks using the same synth, take a look at the bus track number associated to the MIDI track interested. To retrieve the main synth interface, just right-click on the bus track interested and go to Soft Synth Properties. You can also get extra samples, loops, and synthesizers from contests and downloads by using the MAGIX Download Manager. Check it out! If you click and slide above the timeline, you create a yellow loop region used to select limited portions inside the timeline. For example, if you enable the Loop Playback button, you playback just the yellow region continuously. Very useful in case you are editing it. Inside ACID Pro, you can browse and import special audio effects, such as the new EFX, the Vandal, and the AM track effects. From the Plugin Manager window, browse for the right effect and drag and drop it on the audio clip interested. You can also use the FX icon on the clips to look for the right effect and import it through the Add button. As you add effects on the clip, the plugin chain is built with all the effects applied in order from left to right. You can click and slide each effect to change its position and use its square button to enable or disable it. You can edit and adjust the effect properties by clicking on its name and using its interface at the bottom. To remove the effect from the chain, just select it and use the Remove Selected Plugin button. You can also apply effects on a whole audio track by using its FX icon. If you add effects to the master track, these will affect all the clips inside your project. You can also add effects to a MIDI track by using the FX icon on the bus track that is realizing its output sound. Now, let's see how to save and export your project on ACID Pro. To save the project with all its clips and options, just use Save As. ACID projects are saved as .acd project files. To render and export the whole project content, just go to File and then to Render As. Then define where to save the file and its name. Under Save As Type, select the correct audio format and advanced options under Template. In case you have visual clips on your project, you can also export as a .avi video file. Moreover, if you enable Render Loop Region Only, you will export just the part of the timeline that is under the loop region. Thanks for watching this guide. Check out our channel for additional free videos and tips on other important software products.